Good morning. Yes, it's still morning. Doesn't feel like it. But I wanted to switch gears this morning after some great discussion about consumer energy efficiency and data infrastructure. We're going to be talking about commercial energy efficiency. And we're going to get local. We're going to get really local and talk about this particular building. Okay, thank you. So we're in the Eisenhower Executive Building. It's a building that was built in 1888, and it was went through a major renovation in 1999. The building's 660,000 square feet, and it houses primarily offices and administrative support staff. Anyone want to guess what the energy bill annually for this building is?
$4 million.
It's pretty close. It's about $3 million annually, and that comprises electricity, steam, and natural gas. Is that too high, or is it just about right? Or asked another way, is this building using energy as efficiently as it possibly can? And the way one would find that out today is by getting a highly qualified energy engineer into this building, take stock of all the equipment, interview all the facility managers, look at past historical energy bills, and roughly about a month or 6 weeks later, deliver a report that identifies how and where energy goes into this building and what actions can be taken to reduce energy consumption. Let's extrapolate that out to the rest of the country. There are 5.2 million commercial buildings in the United States that roughly consume about 20% of our nation's total energy consumption. Out of those buildings, from the smallest pizza store to the largest convention center, studies have shown that anywhere from 40 to 50% of that energy is routinely wasted. The Better Buildings Challenge, which you've heard about this morning, as well as many mandates by city, state, and local governments, are aiming to reduce consumption in commercial buildings between 20 and 30% in the next decade. So if it takes about a month to do one energy audit to inform a building owner what they can do to reduce consumption, it will take us 400,000 person years just to inform building owners what the problem they have with their buildings is and what they can do to reduce consumption. And at that point, you haven't saved a single kilowatt hour. You've just informed people what they can do. So we're not going to meet our energy efficiency goals, certainly not in commercial buildings, in 400,000 years, okay? We have to do something different. In fact, we have to do something that's exponentially different. And that's what First Fuel was started to accomplish. We are leveraging energy data to dramatically change the game in how energy efficiency is achieved in the commercial building sector. So if President Eisenhower were alive today, arguably he'd press the blue button, but a doctor would look at the data from a whole body MRI and read that information to identify what ails the president and come up with remedies to address those ailments. Most commercial buildings, like this one, today collect information every 15 minutes about the consumption of the whole building. And a chart like this, does it have a pointer? Sorry, can I go back? There we go. So a chart like this captures data every 15 minutes, and every pixel on that is a consumption data point color-coded to identify what the intensity of the consumption is at that point, from the lowest point of consumption to the highest point of consumption. So across every single line represents 24 hours of consumption, and that entire chart represents a year's worth of historical consumption. Just like a doctor reads the whole body MRI, First Fuel's analytics scan through and identify patterns of usage in that consumption history, such as when do people come, when do people leave, when do the systems in the building turn on and off, which days are occupied, which days are unoccupied, and for every hour of every day for the whole year, we can correlate how the consumption changes as hourly temperature, hourly humidity, hourly sun and hourly wind conditions change. So now, without ever setting foot in the building, we can, for this building, not based on what the building should be doing from theoretical models, not based on what other buildings like it are doing, but based on its actual energy consumption, we can now identify where the energy in this building went last year. For example, 45% of the consumption in this building went into HVAC, about 15% went into lighting. Benchmark each one of those end uses and analyze them to identify which end use is efficient and inefficient, and come up with recommendations to address energy conservation in the building. In this building, we found 15% savings opportunities on the electric side and 24% savings opportunity on the district steam side, collectively $500,000 worth of energy savings, in large part just through a set of operational changes that do not require any retrofit investment. Energy data has the ability to unlock energy efficiency in the commercial building sector at extremely large scale. Besides the data that I just showed you, which is the meter data from a utility, or in this case from the GSA, we used open data from the Weather Service, and we used GIS mapping data to understand the physical characteristics of the building. So without ever stepping foot on this, on site, we now are working with the GSA in a recent pilot, identified $4.5 million worth of savings by analyzing 13 million square feet of office space that represented $1.2 billion KBTUs of consumption annually. So the way we get from where we are today and to where we would like to get to within 10 years is by analyzing meter data and unlocking that data through smart analytics to drive repeatable, trustable, and bankable savings. And that's how we're going to make energy efficiency the true first field. Thank you.